Today is the second class of demography. And in this class, we will discuss the demographic transition and population pyramid. So first of all, demographic transition. It is also known as demographic cycle. So demographic transition is the concept that is based on the European experience of population change, and it is a change in a population which undergoes from high birth and death rates to low births and death rates. So the history of world population has five stages through which a nation passes through transition. So from the ancient time, hundreds of years ago, the nations are in demographic transition period. And it has five stages through which the nation is passing during the transition. And the first, that is the high stationary stage. Second is early expanding stage. Third, late expanding stage. Fourth, low stationary stage. And fifth, that is the stage of decline. So the first stage, that is the high stationary stage. Here the high birth rates, high unpredictable death rates cancel each other, and the population remains stationary. So when there are high birth rates and along with there are high death rates, so both are canceling each other, and the result, the population remains stationary, and it is the time period of hundreds years ago at which the European countries passed, and it was the period of famine, droughts, the diseases, epidemics and pandemics were there, and there were wars around the globe. So a stage for much of human history, traditional societies where people were susceptible to diseases. So there were many pandemics like plague, cholera, and other diseases, which caused the increased number of mortality or deaths. And family planning services were non-existent in those days. People have lots of children because many infants die. So the child mortality and infant mortality was very much high. The death rate was high due to poor health care. Due to poor health care services, the death rates were at high. And the population structure, even life expectancy of the ordinary population was very low. So the population is made up of mainly young people. So in this stage, the life expectancy of that nation is very much low, so the population that is made up or comprises mainly of young people. And practically no country today in this first stage of demographic cycle. The second stage, that is the early expanding stage. In this stage, death rate begins to decline while births remain unchanged, and the resulting rising growth rates. So death rate fallen due to improved health care. Even there was improvement, water and sanitation, and improvement in the medicine. Even at that time, there was a lack of family planning services. There was availability, but lack of availability of family planning services were there. And in this second stage, Bangladesh, Iraq, Nepal is in the second stage of demographic cycle or demographic transition. The third stage, that is the late expanding stage. Death rate declines still further in this stage, and birth rate tends to fall. Lower death rate in particular due to decrease in infant mortality rate, due to improvement in the medicine, availability of clean and safe water, and disposal of waste, improvement in sanitation reduced the infant mortality rate worldwide. The growth rates declined from high to lower levels. Economic change, there was urbanization, and even incentives to have fewer children, like China. And even some countries given the incentives to the family to limit their family size, like China. Given the incentive to family that was called as a one child phenomena. So they given the incentive to the family that if they have a one children, all the education will be free, all the health care will be free, and all the other civics of the life will be free if the family has one child. It was incentive was given to the families some decades ago in the China. So changes, there was a change in the women's role, and there was increase gender equity and equality. Even the literacy rate in females increased, so women become empowered. There was a better health care and better education. And in this late expanding stage comes Pakistan, India, and China. The fourth stage, that is low stationary stage, in which low birth rate and low death rate result in stationary population. Better education, more affluent cultural attitudes towards smaller families and societies went to the nuclear families. There was an improved standard of living and socio-economic development. Zero growth rate has already been recorded in Austria during 1980 to 1985. Other examples are Sweden, United States and Canada. So they have a zero population growth rate. The fifth stage, that is the stage of decline or a declining stage, in which birth rate is lower than death rates. Population begins to decline due to decline in growth rates. If the birth rates drops below the death rate, it will produce negative growth rate or minus growth rate. Proportion of elderly population is increasing in this stage. Western Europe, Japan, Italy, Spain, Germany, and Hungary have negative growth rate. So you can see the diagram showing the demographic transition, and here these are the birth rate and here these are the death rate. This is the stage one, high stationary, then the early expanding, late expanding, and low stationary stage, stage number four. Here the births and deaths cancel each other. So the demographic transition, in this transition, first there were high birth rates and high death rates, then improved living standards, health care caused death rates to drop, finally to low birth rates match low death rates. The transition is advancing in more or less developed countries. Some countries have already attained replacement level. The transition is rapid in developing countries, while it is slow in less developed countries. The pace of transition depends on culture, socioeconomic development, migration pattern, urbanization, and family values. The second topic, that is the population pyramid. So the population pyramid is, it is a graphical or pictorial presentation of the age and sex structure of the population. The young ones in the population are represented at the bottom and the old ones at the top of the pyramid. The age representation is in the group of 5 years. Pakistan's population pyramid is a typical pyramidal structure, which shows that the number of people here at each successive age is likely to be smaller. There is a gross difference in the shape of population pyramid of the developing and developed countries. Demographically, the structure of population pyramid of any country depends upon fertility rates, mortality rates, and migration pattern of that country. And what is a population pyramid? It is a diagram that gives information about the proportion of males and females in each group. Also shows proportion of young people from 0 to 14, proportion of working group, that is 15 to 59 age groups, and proportion of elderly people, that is the 60 and 60 plus age population. How to read a population parameter? Read the title, country or city or racial group. Comment on a general shape of pyramid. Note the proportion of people in various age groups. Note the sex ratio. And we have to interpret the data of that population pyramid of that nation. So this is the population pyramid of India. Vertical axis, which shows the age groups into the 5 years of group, and the horizontal axis, which shows the percentage or numbers of population, that is in millions. Males on the left side and female on the right side. It shows the young dependent group from 0 up to 14. Elderly dependent, that is from 65 and more years of age population, elderly dependent, and the working population from 15 up to 59 years. This is the population pyramid of United Kingdom. Percentage of total population. Here, the vertical axis, which shows the age group in 5 years of age. The females on right side, males on the left side. The old dependent, economically active group, young dependent, 0 to 14 years of age, males on the left and females on the right. So the shapes of population pyramid. The first shape, that is the spike shape. Spike shape pyramid. This pyramid, population pyramid, shows high birth rate and high death rate. Low growth rate, so there is, this country will be in equilibrium because the high birth rate cancels the high death rate. So there will be low growth rate. It is characteristic of primitive demographic equilibrium and is seen in non-industrialized countries like the Kenya. The second shape, that is the barrel shape behind. It shows, this barrel shape population pyramid shows low birth rate and low death rate. So low growth rate or zero population growth. This population will be in equilibrium. The barrel is characterized by a narrow base with little further narrowing until the apex. Depicting low birth rate and low death rate. It is typically of developed countries population pyramid in evolved demographic equilibrium. The third shape, that is the wedge shape, also known as paramedian shape. It shows high birth rate, low death rate. So the growth rate is very much higher. This country is in the process of demographic transition. The wage is characteristic of a wide base. This is wide base and gradually narrowing the population pyramid, which shows high birth rate at the base and low death rate. It represents the marked imbalance in dependency ratio and serious socio-economic stress will be in this country. An example is Pakistan. So we can see the population pyramid according to the demographic transition stage one, in which the population pyramid of that country in stage one, their population pyramid will be expansive, concave sides. It will show high birth rate, high death rate, and in this stage one, the life expectancy will be short. Rapid fall in each upward age group due to high death rate. And the second stage of demographic transition population pyramid, it is also expansive, but straight sides, is still high birth rate, falling death rate, slightly longer life expectancy, fall in death rates. Stage three in demographic transition, in this population pyramid, the population will be in stationary stage and the sides are convex sides. Declining birth rate, low death rate, long life expectancy. And in the fourth demographic transition, the population pyramid will look like this one. This is the population which will be in contractive stage. And convex sides of the population pyramid shows low birth rate, low death rate, and longer life expectancy, higher dependency ratio. So again, the population pyramid according to the demographic transition models, stage one, stage two, stage three, and stage four. So in stage one, the Scotland was before 1760, but currently Guinea and other African countries fall in stage one. And in stage two, Scotland was from 1760 up to 1830. And in the second stage, nowadays, Republic Congo comes. And in the third stage, late expanding stage, Scotland was in 1800 to 1950. And currently, Algeria, Tunisia, and Morocco comes in this stage. And late stationary stage, Scotland, Japan, and USA terms. So we can use this population pyramid in comparison with the other countries. So you can see here that this is the population pyramid of Kenya and it is looking like a spike shape and it shows the rapid growth rate. And the second, that is the population pyramid of United States. and it shows low birth rates and it has slow growth, and the Italy, it has zero growth or the growth rate is in negative. Again, the comparison of population pyramid, rapid growth, the demographic Republic of Congo, slow growth, that is the United States, and negative growth, that is the Germany. And it is the comparison of Pakistan, that is with the Germany. Here, the Pakistan population pyramid is paramedian in shape. So what information is obtained from population pyramid of any country? The first, the age structure of that country. Sex composition or sex ratio. Males versus females. The birth rate or fertility pattern of that country. Death rate or mortality. Migration pattern. We can see the dependency ratio. Women at childbearing age. What is the fertility level? And we can predict the past, and we can observe the past or imagine the past population, and we can predict the future trend of population, that is known as population movement. The demographic transition, we can see, we can observe from the population pyramid. Median age of population by gender, mortality levels by age and gender, and a clue about the calamities like the infant mortality, child mortality, and the burden of the disease. So here the population pyramid comparison, the Pakistan 1970s. And 2000, it is the population pyramid which is looking, predicting the population of Pakistan of 2025. So this is the population pyramid which is predicting the population of Pakistan of 2025. Even this is the comparison of prediction of population of Pakistan of 2050. So what is the importance of population pyramid? Making policies and planning for future, how much future health services will be needed and how much houses will be required according to the increase in population, and even the future number of schools required will be detected or identified. How much employment or jobs will be needed according to the growth rate. And population pyramid can be used for comparison with other countries. The second one, that is the dependency ratio. The definition of dependency ratio is the ratio of dependence people younger than 15 and older than 64 and plus to working age population to those of ages 15 to 64 years. So proportion of persons above 65 years of age and below 15 years of age are considered dependent on economically productive age group, that is 15 to 64 years of age group. The data are shown as the proportion of dependent per 100 working age population. The ratio of combined age groups 0 to 15 years plus 65 years and above to the 15 to 65 years age group is referred as a total dependency ratio. The dependency ratio can also be divided into young age dependency ratio, that is 0 to 14 years, and old age dependency ratio, that is 65 years and more. So this is the formula to calculate total dependency ratio, that is children from 0 to 14 years of age plus more than 65 years of age divided by population of economical active group, that is 15 to 64 years of age group, and it is multiplied by 100. Child dependency ratio, that is the children from 0 to 14 years of age and divided by population of 15 to 64 years of age multiplied by 100. Old dependency ratio, that is the population more than 65 years of age divided by population of 15 to 64 years of age multiplied by 100. So this will be old dependency ratio. So Pakistan dependency ratios, total dependency ratio is 60.4%, and youth or young dependency ratio, that is 53.3%, and elderly dependent ratio, that is 7.1%. The other term used in demography, that is the density of the population. Density of the population is defined as the number of persons living per square kilometer is known as population density. It is the ratio between total population and surface land area. Population density is mid-year population divided by land area in square kilometers. So population density is equal to number of persons divided by 1 square kilometers. Pakistan, the population density, average population density is 234 persons per square kilometer, which was in 2018. And in Karachi, population density is more than 2000, and in Hyderabad it is about 178 persons per kilometer. And what is the sex ratio? The overall sex ratio is simply the ratio of males to the females in the population. It is calculated by taking the number of males in a population and dividing it by the number of females in the same population. The sex ratio, number of males, number of females, and it is presented into the percentage, so multiplied by 100. So in Pakistan, total population, that is the 1.06 males versus to the females. And the second topic, that is the fertility rates. And what is fertility? Fertility means the actual bearing of the children. Some demographers use the word natality in place of fertility. A woman's reproductive period is calculated roughly from 15 to 45 years, a period of 30 years. A woman married at the age of 15 and living 45 years with her husband is exposed to the risk of pregnancy for 30 years and may give birth to average of 15 years, but this maximum is rarely achieved. The fertility depends upon several factors. For example, high fertility in Pakistan is attributed to due to universality of the marriage, lower age at marriage, even low level of literacy, poor level of living, limited use of contraceptives and traditional ways of life. So the first age of marriage, it has great impact on fertility. Many research surveys have found that female who marry before the age of 18 give birth to a larger number of children than those who married after 18 years. Early marriages is a long-standing custom in Pakistan. The national average age of marriage is 20.5 years. The exceptions are more in the rural areas, where a large proportion of the marriages continue to take place, where the girls are below 16 years of age. The legal age of marriage, child marriage is in Pakistan is legally prohibited to an extent under the Child Marriage Restraint Act 1929. Under the Act, minimum age for the marriage is 18 years for a male and 16 years for a female. So child marriages are, it is being dealt with according to this Act, or Child Marriage Act. Duration of marriage. Studies have indicated that 10 to 20% of all births occur within 1 to 5 years of married life, and from 50 to 55% of all births occur within the 5 to 15 years of married life. This suggests that family planning efforts should be concerned in the first few years of married life in order to achieve results. Spacing of the children. Studies have shown that when all births are postponed by 1 year in each age group, there was a decline in total fertility. It follows that spacing of children may have a significant impact on general reduction in fertility rates. Education have inverse association. So there is an inverse association between fertility and educational status. Education provides knowledge, increased expert information and media. Education builds skill for gainful employment, increase female participation in family decision making, and raises the opportunity cost of women's time and wages. Total fertility rate is 1.7 children higher for illiterate women with at least a high school education. The economic status bears an inverse relationship with fertility. The total number of children born declines with the increase in per capita expenditure of the household. The World Population Conference in Bucharest, in fact, stressed that economic development is the best contraceptive. It will take care of population growth and bring about reduction in fertility. Caste and religion. Muslims have higher fertility than Hindus, and Hindus have higher fertility than Christians. Nutrition. Virtually all well-fed societies have low fertility, and poor-fed societies have high fertility. The effect of nutrition on fertility is largely indirect. Family planning. In many developing countries, family planning is a key factor in declining fertility. Programs require limited resources as compared to the others. So fertility is affected by a number of physical, biological, social, and cultural factors such as place of women in society, value of children in society, widow marriages, breastfeeding, customs and beliefs, industrialization, urbanization, better health conditions, housing, opportunities for women, and government policies. And there are different types of fertility rates. The crude fertility rate, also known as crude birth rate, age-specific fertility rate, and total fertility rate. Crude birth rate, it is the simplest indicator of fertility and is defined as the number of live births per 1,000 estimated mid-year population in a given year. The crude birth rate is an unsatisfactory measure of fertility because the total population is not exposed to the childbearing. General fertility rate, it is the number of live births per 1,000 women at a childbearing age in a given year. It is a better measure of fertility than crude birth rate because the denominator is restricted to the women of childbearing age, that is from 15 to 49 years. Major drawback of this rate is that not all women in the denominator are exposed to the risk of childbirth or pregnancy. The age-specific fertility rate. More precise measure of fertility is age-specific fertility rate. It is defined as the number of live births in a year to 1,000 women in any specified age group. So age-specific fertility rate threw light on the fertility pattern in any community. They are also sensitive indicator of family planning achievements. So this is the age-specific fertility rate. The age groups, women of childbearing in 5 years age group and their age-specific fertility rate according to their age group. The total fertility rate, average number of children a woman would have if she were to pass through her reproductive years at the same rates as the woman now in each group. It is calculated by summing the age-specific fertility rates for all ages. If 5 years age groups are used, the sum of the rate is multiplied by 5. This measure gives the approximate magnitude of completed family size. So the total fertility rate is sum of the all age specific fertility rates multiplied by 5, like this one. So this is the age specific fertility rate, and it is being summing. When we are summing all the age specific fertility rate, the answer is 0.955. And as it is in the 5 years group, so multiplying, we are multiplying this total with the 5. And the answer is 4.775. This is the total fertility rate of TFR. The total fertility rate can be used for comparison purpose. It is the condensed form of age-specific fertility rates. It is the most widely used demographic measure. It is most common use is projection of population. So the total fertility rate of Pakistan in 1998, it was 4.8, and it is 2008 estimate, that is about 2.9. The causes of high fertility rates: poverty, early marriages, extended families, low socioeconomic condition, illiteracy, religion, and pro-natalistic policies. And what are the causes of low fertility? More education and awareness, high socioeconomic status, anti-natalistic policies, and nuclear families. Why does high fertility matter? It produces population overgrowth, which is responsible for environmental degradation, in which the air pollution, noise pollution, deforestation all comes. Unavailability of basic civics facilities will be available to the common population, and it will face the socio-economic development problems. And in the health point of view, the maternal and child health problems will be there. Maternal nutritional deprivation, it will lead to malnutrition and anemia, IUGR, intrauterine growth retardation, low birth weight babies, and it will lead to high maternal and high infant mortality. And what are the mortality rates? Crude death rate, it is the total number of deaths per 1,000 mid-year population in a given year. And age-specific mortality rate, this is the number of deaths in age X to Y years, the total population at the same age group. There, these are the most important and refined mortality rates, as they are not affected by the age structure of the population. These are also used for the projection of population by ages. These can be computed for males and females separately. Infant mortality rate, number of deaths of infants in a given year into total divided by total number of live births in the same year multiplied by 1,000. It is mostly used health indicator in the world. This health indicator is significant for countries' socio-economic development. A little adjustment is required while computing IMR. Maternal mortality ratio, number of women dying due to pregnancy in a given year. Number of women dying due to pregnancy in a given year divided by total number of live births in the same year and multiplied by 1 lakh. The maternal mortality rate, number of women dying due to pregnancy in a given year divided by total number of women at childbearing age in the same year multiplied by 100,000, means multiplied by 1 lakh. This is the definition of maternal mortality rate. Thank you.